We are about to put some stuff together. A bunch of ingredients, and this Excel tutorial is gonna taste better than any Excel tutorial you ever tasted in your life. And if it doesn't, you gotta run to the doctor and say, "Doctor, my tongue has malfunctioned. I'm in trouble. Please help me." XLOOKUP has been revised. I'm going to show you XLOOKUP version 3.0. I'm going to show you the Intellisense in Power Query so that we can write a formula. We're going to do one of the six joins in Power Query. You ready to get to cooking this thing? Let's do it. We've got all of these trips that were taken. We want to get the agent, the code, the airport name, and the state for the last arrival for each of these agents. For Bristol, what was Bristol's last trip? We want to grab DAY, and I think that's the Dayton, Ohio airport. Let's get the codes. Equals XLOOKUP. Look up what? Andy. Comma. Look up array. We're going to look for Andy here in this table. Comma. Return what? We want to return the last arrival. All right. Comma. If not found, this is what's new about XLOOKUP version 3.0. The if not found has been moved to the fourth position and is no longer in the sixth position. All right. If somebody is not found, let's put no travel, double quote, comma, search mode, exact match, comma, search last to first, negative one, close parentheses, enter. All right, Andy has not traveled. Let's send this down. Now, how do we get the airport name and the state? I've got a URL where I'm going to import from a web page, and then we got to clean this data up. All right. Data, get data from other sources, from web. Here's the URL, paste, okay. What do we want to get? Let's see, document, no, table. That's what we want, all right? So I'm going to transform the data. Now this is tricky. Look how this data is set up. We've got Alabama and AL, and then all of the airports in Alabama. And then it skips to Alaska. We need a column for the states, but the states are mixed in with the airport names. Here's how we're gonna dig this out. I'm gonna add a column, custom column. Now I know that each state has a two-letter abbreviation and every airport has a three-letter abbreviation. Here we go. I'm gonna just put in length. Look at that. Now Intellisense is giving me some suggestions. All right, I think text length is what we want. Click that. Open parentheses. And I want to look at the text length in column 2. Close parentheses. Enter. Look at that. It is getting the text length. So I'm going to go back and modify this formula. If that text length is equal to 2, then grab what's in column 1. Else, null. Okay, look at that. Beautiful. Right click, fill, down. Now we've got to get rid of the states. Here's how I'm going to do that. Add a conditional column. If column 1 equals that custom column, then put an X, otherwise empty. Okay, now I'm gonna filter out everything that has an X, and then get rid of this column, remove it. I'm gonna name this query airports, then close and load it as a connection only. Now we need an agents query, here we go. Data, here we go. Table has headers. Call this agents. I'm gonna close and load this as a connection only. Okay. Now I'm ready to do my merge. Data, get data. Combine queries, merge. I want my agents query and then the airports query. I want to match column 2 with code. Left out a join, okay. Now we're going to expand. Don't want to use that. All right, so let's see. We don't need this column. Right click, remove. Got the agent code. Airport name. Then state. I'm gonna sort this. Then I'm gonna close and load this to the workbook. Okay. Get rid of this. That is what we wanted. We put all the ingredients together. We use the Intellisense merges, XLOOKUP 3.0. We put a lot of stuff together in this dish, and you better believe it's delicious. If you can't taste all that goodness, you gotta go look in the mirror and see, is your tongue still there? That's the first thing. And if it is, go see a doctor. See you in the next video.